Lactate. Hey guys, I'm Tom, and I still have makeup on my face from Halloween last night. Okay, so today I'm going to be talking to you about types of stress and how they can kill you. Okay, so stress can be good in small amounts, but literally can screw you up if you cannot put a cap on it or are able to control it. There are three different types of stress, and those different three types are acute, chronic, and traumatic. Acute stress is pretty much what you think it is. Small amounts of stress caused by specific events, for example, like giving a speech or taking a test. Now, chronic stress is where we get a little more like in depth. It's caused by repeated exposure to an event that will cause the body to release a specific hormone. Now, what your brain releases for the purposes of this video, we will call it stress hormones. For example, say you have four other tests to take that day as well, which I would probably want to die as well, but they're spread out over the course of a week. This is what can cause chronic stress. You know it's coming, and it happens by repeated exposure of the same event. Like, you have a test Monday, you have a test Tuesday, you have a test Wednesday, you have a test Thursday. This can also be related to conditioning, which was tested and proven by Ivan Pavlov. So now whenever you have to take a test, you will become stressed out. So it is kind of a big circle. Big circle. And it's a very bad big circle because it never really goes away. For example, for me, when I had this class every morning about 3 years ago, and I would always have it right when I wake up because our schedule never changed. But now, so it was like 7:30 right in the morning, I would always have this class, and we would do these warm-ups. And now, every single time I have this class for the past 3 years, after the schedule has changed, so now our days rotate, every single time we do warm-ups, I always yawn, because I was so tired in the morning when we did warm-ups. But now, even if I have it at the end of the day, I yawn, because I was conditioned for an entire year to yawn when we did warm-ups. And the last type of stress is traumatic stress. This is caused by an event that emotionally overwhelms you. Now, it's close to, it has a relationship with like PTSD. It's not really post-traumatic stress disorder. There is really no other stress disorder, other like big traumatic stress disorder, other than post-traumatic stress disorder. There are others, but they're not very well known, or they're very rare. Okay, so acute stress can be actually good for you. It doesn't even cause you any problems whatsoever. You don't really know that it's there until it's actually like gone or was happening, basically. But basically what happens is the whole process is the stress hormone is released from your hypothalamus in your brain, which controls everything from body temperature to lactation in females, not in males. So, for example, adrenaline is released from your hypothalamus, which puts your energy and strength and speed first, and digestion and like everything else in the back seat. And this can be compared to your sympathetic nervous system, your parasympathetic nervous system, all that fun jazz, your autonomic nervous system, blah, blah, blah. But when you are experiencing chronic stress constantly, these hormones being released all the time can screw up your mood and your daily body functions, which, you know, we don't want to happen. Okay guys, so I know this video was short for me, but I will be releasing a new video soon about serial killers being born in the month of November. Crazy, right? Be sure to check out for it real soon. It'll be posted in a few days, hopefully. And be sure to check out our website, psych2go.net. Don't forget to like and subscribe. Leave comments below on what stresses you out. I want to know. Love ya. See ya. Bye.